Okay, welcome back to our next video. In this one, actually, we will see the solid solution alloys. Okay, the last class we have discussed about this particular classification, and out of which we will see this particular portion in this video lecture. Okay, the solid solution alloy is further classified into substitutional and interstitial alloys. Okay, now let us see what you mean by a solid solution alloy. Solid solution alloy in which the metal completely soluble in each other. Okay, those metals which combines in this fashion are said to form solid solutions, and corresponding alloy is known as solid solution alloy. So these are the most of the alloys comes under in this category of the solid solution alloys. In this one we will take two different metals. Okay, two different metals, and those metals will be melted and they will be joined together. So this is known as a solid solution alloy. Okay, the particularity is that when this type of alloy solidifies, actually we will get only one type of crystals. Okay, one regular pattern crystals will be formed. Okay, under microscope this crystalline structure look like a pure metal, so it is very difficult to differentiate it from the pure metal, because since the crystalline arrangement is regular pattern, so we cannot it's very hard, most of the cases 90% it is very difficult to identify that it's of different material. And the next slide we will see how it will look like. So solid solution alloys have similar property that of a pure material. Okay, since the crystalline nature or the crystalline structure is of regular pattern, so it will not have much deviation from our pure metal, but their strength, they will not compromise in their strength. This is basically due to the size, the heavy size of the atom which will be replaced the original atoms. Okay, so high hardness, it's having higher hardness than the pure metals. However, the poor thermal and electrical conductivities is a noticeable change. Okay, so if your application is for electrical or thermal conductivities, this kind of alloys is not recommended. Okay, so now moving to the next slide. So this is basically a schematic diagram, but this is for easy representation, but this is actually, if you look through a microscope, you will see like this. Okay, this is a solid solution. This looks like a solid solution. So these red atoms represent one kind of element, and the blue atom represent another kind of element. So here in a solid solution, you can see that how orderly it is arranged. So that means it is completely soluble. So, and it is very difficult to differentiate this one in a microscope. So but here if you see, this is a mixture of solid solution, means some diffusions happen to this area, and some diffusion happen to this areas also. So we can say that it's a mixture, that means it is a partially soluble. Okay, third one is completely insoluble, that means not a single atom have moved or crossed the green boundary and moved to other. So it will this will look at like a particular region having a particular element and another particular region having another particular element. So this is a mixture of pure crystals, crystallites. So we cannot say that this is such a not, and this will not be a good because this if such kind of alloys are formed, it will be subjected to many damages or some defects and all. Okay, so that's about the thing. Now moving to the classifications of solid solution alloys, it is widely classified into two types. The first one is the substitutional, and second one is the interstitial. Okay, here we can see that in substitutional you can see these examples, and here what will happen is that the new atom, which is of red color, will replace some existing atom or will come as a substitute for the existing atom, and it will replace their position. And next is the interstitial type. In interstitial type, what they will these red atoms will look, or the new atoms will take the place, okay, the interstitial spaces of these bigger atoms. Okay, what will happen is that if it take place the interstitial atoms, it will obviously it will increases its density. You can see that this one can be easily identified by higher density, and it will induce some compressive stresses in between. So what will happen is that it obviously it will increases the strength. And okay, so the you can see in this one in some kind of ceramics, ionic crystals and all. So this is a much more clear representation. So this is the parent atom, this is substitutional atom, and this one in interstitial, this is the allowing atom which took take the place of the interstitial spaces, and this is the parent atom. So this one to happen, actually we need this atom should be of very small size, like approximately should be the size of the interstitial spaces between the atoms. Okay, here the condition is that the substitution atom should be as like it should be somewhat similar in size to the parent atom. Okay, so this is what I want to tell you. This is a particular arrangement here. Here this is known as a super lattice. Super lattice means the substitution is of a regular, like it is of ordered nature, like it's of a regular pattern. If it arranges in a regular pattern, such kind of arrangement is known as a super lattice. Okay, super lattice. So the substitution, the examples are like, we can cite the example of brass and sterling silver. So the substitutional solid state alloys are further like classified. This one we have already discussed, but these two are also there. This is known as a random arrangement. That means you can see there is no particular order of the arrangement. So this is a random arrangement. Here we have a regular order, as seen in the brass and all, regular arrangement or regular order is there. But here the next one is known as a clustered one. Okay, this is known as the clustered portion. So in clustered portion, actually we some group of alloys will come, group of atoms of the alloying element will come and cluster together at the center, or some at a particular portion. So this is known as a clustered substitutional SS. So this is all about substitutional solution alloys. So in the next video we will go and we will check with the we'll check with the intermetallic solutions. Okay, so that's all. Thank you.